let's open this question. Rule number one, apply identity, you don't have any. Convert into sine cos, let's convert this. Cot is cos upon cos. Cosec is 1 upon
sine.
Minus 1 upon 1. Just to maintain that. Okay. Remember one thing, when you have more than two fractions in a question, try to write it this way. Divided by this thing. Cot is cos A upon sin A minus 1 upon sin A plus 1 upon 1. Fine? Take and see. Sin A. There is cos A plus 1 minus sin A. Because it doesn't have sin, so we will multiply sin A. What about this? We have sin A and LCM. So cos A minus 1 plus sin A. Divide. Then this is what the right hand side. Cos A plus 1 minus divided by sin A multiplied sin A upon cos A plus sin A minus 1. Just keeping the minus sign at the end. Fine? So sin A got cancelled. So we have cos A plus 1 minus sin upon cos A plus sin A minus 1. So we are stuck here. We can see our rules. Do we have any identity to apply? No. Convert it into sin cos, already done. Take LCM, we have taken that and solved that also. Use identity, you can't use any identity. If nothing works,
rationalize.
Do rationalize.
Sir, but like for three terms, how are the signs?
See, we don't require three terms for one term. What we can do, is take these two terms as one and separate then this terms. Let me do it for you. Cos A plus sin A plus 1. Okay. Cos A plus sin A plus 1. Got it? Then what we will do? We will multiply cos A into all of the three. See, cos A into all three. Cos into cos.
Cos
square. Cos into sin.
Cos
A sin. Sin A. Cos into 1 plus cos A. Now we will take 1. Understood?
Plus cos A.
Plus cos A.
Plus sin A.
Plus sin A.
Plus 1.
Plus 1. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Now, minus sin. Minus sin.
Minus cos. Sin
minus
cos A.
Minus sin A.
Cos A.
Cos A. Minus
sin square A.
Sin square A. Minus
sin.
Oh, this is wrong. Fine? And in the denominator, whenever we do rationalization, we get a square minus b square. We got cos A plus
sin
A whole square minus 1 square. Clear? Okay, let's see. anything got cancelled. See, cos sin a. This is plus and this is minus. So, cancel. Anything else? Anything else? Same. Sine. Got cancelled. Anything else? I don't think so. So, let's write in a formula. This is cos square a, then minus sin square a, fine? This is
plus
2 cos a.
Plus 1.
Anything else left?
No.
Here, identity. A square plus
B square
plus 2 sine a cos a.
Why can't we take A square minus B square is equal to A plus B into A minus B?
We will get this thing only. Okay.
Oh.
Understood. We got it from here now. So here, A square plus B square plus 2AB. Minus 1. See the interesting thing. Sin square a plus cos square is what?
1.
We got 1. And 1 minus 1?
Cancel
out in the denominator. Let me just write it for you. So we got cos square a minus sin square a. Let's focus on that thing also. What do we need? We need cos. Okay? And we have here 2 cos. So, should I remove this sign? How should I remove this sign? Let's see. Sin square a plus cos square a is what? 1. Sin square a equals to 1 minus
cos
square. Can I get this?
Mm-hmm.
So, instead of sin square a, can I write it that? Let's write that. Could I write it here? Good. Cos square a minus, focus, minus 1, minus, plus cos square. Got it? It was 1 minus cos square, but because of this minus, it got changed. Plus 2 cos a. Minus, sorry, plus 1. Fine?
Plus 1.
Fine? Later on. Mm-hmm. In the next step, obviously. Here, 1, minus 1, 0. So we got only 2 cos a sin. 2 sin a cos a. 2 sin a cos a. Cool? Now, this one, we have cancelled with that one. So we are left with 2 cos square a plus 2 cos a. So can I? Okay, let's write it down first. It's 2 cos square a plus
2 cos a.
And we have 2 sin a cos a. Can I take common in the denominator? What is common? We have 2 common and cos a is common. So we are left with 1 cos and nothing. That is 1. 2 sin a cos a. So 2 to cancel, cos a cos got cancelled. So the answer is cos a plus 1 upon
sin
a. What do we need? Oh, it does.